Hello and welcome to Now You Know. These are my top 7 picks from Leonardo da Vinci's inventions. Number 7. The self-propelled cart. The self-propelled cart was one of the many inventions that Leonardo created dealing with locomotion and transportation. Leonardo's cart was powered by coiled springs, and it also featured steering and brake capabilities. When the brake was released, the car would propel forward. Da Vinci's cart design was so ahead of its time that its exact workings baffled scholars until late in the 20th century. But in 2006, Italy's Institute and Museum of the History of Science in Florence built a working model based on Da Vinci's design, and, to the surprise of many, the cart actually worked. Number 6. The machine gun. The way Leonardo da Vinci saw it, the problem with the cannons of the time was that they took far too long to load. His solution to that problem was to build multi-barreled guns that could be loaded and fired simultaneously. While one set of cannons was being fired, another set would be cooling and the third set could be loaded. This system allowed soldiers to repeatedly fire without interruption. Leonardo da Vinci's design for the 33-barreled organ is generally regarded as the basis for the modern-day machine gun, a weapon that didn't really develop for commercial use until the 19th century. Number 5. The parachute. Da Vinci made a sketch of the invention with this accompanying description. If a man had a tent made of linen, of which the apertures or openings have all been stopped up, and it be 12 braccia, which is about 23 feet across, and 12 in depth, he will be able to throw himself down from any great height without suffering any injury. Daredevil Adrian Nichols constructed a prototype based on Da Vinci's design and tested it. Despite skepticism from experts, Da Vinci's design worked as intended, and Nichols even noted that it had a smoother ride than the modern parachute. Number 4. The Robot Knight. Designed for a pageant in Milan, which the Duke had put Leonardo in charge of overseeing, the Robot Knight consisted of a knight suit filled with gears and wheels that were connected to an elaborate pulley and cable system. Through these mechanisms, Da Vinci's Robot Knight was capable of independent motion, sitting down, standing up, moving its head, and lifting its visor. Using several different Da Vinci drawings as blueprints, roboticist Mark Rochim built a prototype of the Robotic Knight in 2002, which was able to walk and wave. Number 3. The Diving Suit. Originally designed as a way of warding off invading ships, Da Vinci's diving suit would allow men to engage in a little underwater sabotage by cutting holes in the bottom of the enemy's hull. The leather diving suit was equipped with a bag-like mask that went over the diver's head. Attached to the mask, around the nose area, were two cane tubes that led up to a cork diving bell floating on the surface. Unfortunately, the design, complete with breathing hose and glass goggles, wasn't needed at the time, and would only find itself submerged in planning stages. Number 2. The Armored Tank. The precursor to the modern tank, Leonardo da Vinci's armored car invention was capable of moving in any direction and was equipped with a large number of weapons. The platform was covered by a large protective cover reinforced with metal plates, which was to be slanted to better deflect enemy fire. The motion of the machine was to be powered by 8 men inside of the tank who would constantly turn cranks to spin the wheels. Despite its elaborate design, Da Vinci's tank has a major flaw. The powering cranks went in opposite directions. This made forward motion impossible. Scholars suggest that Da Vinci, a pacifist at heart, may have inserted the flaw intentionally to discourage the war machine from ever being built. And number 1. The Flying Machine. One of Da Vinci's most famous inventions, the flying machine, also known as the ornithopter, ideally displays his powers of observation and imagination. It had a wingspan that exceeded 33 feet, and the frame was to be made of pine covered in raw silk to create a light but sturdy membrane. To power the wings, the pilot would pedal a crank connected to a rod and pulley system. The machine also had a hand crank for increased energy output and a headpiece for steering. Unfortunately, while the flying machine may have flown once it was in the air, a person could never have created enough power to get the device off the ground. You are no longer ignorant concerning these matters. Now you know. Thank you for watching. If you liked this video, consider checking out my video on the Da Vinci painting that affects your life today.